SHREEM BRZEE.
Yeah, hi everyone, Shalini here. Welcome to Testing Mantra. And I'm sorry I did not make any more further video in past 1 year. I just made 2 videos and then I left. And I will tell you how, like, why I left making videos, because it felt stupid for me. Like, I was chanting 108 times of SHREEM BRZEE, and then I was expecting Mahalakshmi to showers like some sort of wealth to me. And after making 2 videos, I recorded 1 or 2 and then I did not post it for some reason, and then my laptop broke and I wasn't able to, but I continued doing the mantra. And then I thought after some days I will post those, but now it really feels those were very superficial videos, and the mantra is really, really deep. And now it's been 1 year I'm practicing that mantra, and I was expecting that time I was going through some financial crisis, and I have heard this mantra on YouTube and on different platforms like Facebook and Instagram. That's why I tried this mantra at first, and I was really doubting it very much. I didn't believe any of it. I thought, like many other fraud babas, this is just a hoax. And really, guys, if you are trying this mantra to get something and to get fast result, it won't work for you. It didn't work for me, but the way it worked for me is really divine, and I wanted to share, because that is the most important thing what has happened with me. It is like after doing for 1 week, I lost the faith on this mantra or any of the mantra, but because I was doing it for 1 week, it got stuck in my mind. So first I chanted it, and then it chanted itself in my head. It was like whenever I'm sleeping, SHREEM BRZEE is happening out of on its own. It's started chanting in me on its own. And then I lost all the expectation out of it, because I wasn't doing it myself. I wasn't expecting anything. I thought, oh, it's just bullshit. How can chanting something will bring you anything? But it did. And what it brings me, I was thinking that I was having some financial crisis, but it wasn't much, and maybe it was in my perception, but maybe I didn't need it. Mahalakshmi given me her love, and not the money, but her love. Whenever I was sleeping, whenever I lie down my head, it's like I'm lying down in Mahalakshmi's lap. It's always like this. And it's like mother's love wherever you go. So no matter where you live, it's like she is always with me, and she is supporting me in mysterious ways, and I am so overwhelmed with it, and so I have a lot of gratitude for it. And when I used to chant this mantra, I was chanting like Shreem Brzee, how it is like written, Shreem and then Brzee. But then when I heard this mantra, when I wasn't chanting this mantra, it doesn't end with M, Shreem, it doesn't end with M. It's like Shreem, 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 Shreem. It's like a tight end of a sitar. When you pull the string, the sound you may hear, it's like that. So Shreem and then Brzee, Shreem Brzee. It's like, so, and then I was really amazed with it. I was enjoying it, and it's like my Lakshmi, an invisible friend, was always with me, a divine invisible friend, and a mom is always with you. So it is really, really, I mean, I can't put it into words. I have very bad vocabulary, but even if a person has a very good vocabulary, they also might find it very difficult to convey what I'm trying to convey. So the important thing is, whenever you chant a mantra or you pick a mantra, there is a deity associated with it. For example, if you are chanting Om Namah Shivaya or Shiva mantra, then Shiva is a yogi deity, first guru is associated with it, and he will help you in your entire life. If you remember him, he will remember you. So I remember Mahalakshmi, and Mahalakshmi is remembering me like this. And the thing is, I didn't expect much from this mantra, and this mantra showered me lot of love. No mother is capable of giving that much of love what Mahalakshmi has given me. Wherever I go, she is with me. And then I started receiving a lot of gold gifts from other friends I didn't expect. So it is all the side effects of this, I would say. So you give your soul to Mahalakshmi, Mahalakshmi give her soul to you. It is like that. It is a give and take, or it is like mother and child relationship. So like a mother, a child may not know what, you know, what he really wants, or it is possible that whatever you want may not be good for you, but a mother knows it, what is good for a child. So that's what Mahalakshmi is giving me. She is giving lots of love, she is giving everything. You know, it feels like I'm in heaven while living on earth, because whenever I sleep, I just fall into her lap, and it feels like she is patting me, and sometimes I can see her glowing face, lovely eyes, and her all the jewelry and radiant face. So I don't know if this result is valid, and I don't know if this is what I am imagining, but if I don't care if at all it is my imagination, it is working for me. So it is up to you. So it's like you don't have to count your mantras like 108 times in the morning, 108 times in the evening, like that. No, you have to dive in it. You have to become one with the mantra for it to work for you. So you have to become one with the mantra. So your every breathing should reverberate the mantra you are chanting, or the mantra should chant itself inside you. So first you have to push it. It's like a cycling. So first you give the kinetic energy with your strength, and it goes into certain point where then you're no longer cycling it. The cycle goes itself for some distance. So when you reach that point, then it started manifesting it in most wonderful ways that you could not imagine how this mantra can help you. So yes, it works. So but you don't need to go anywhere, and you don't need to register for some programs. You can do it at your home, or if you do not have your alone time at home, you do not have a place where you can sit and try this, then you can chant anywhere inside you, and then it will manifest what it has to manifest, and your whole life will become like, oh, this happened. Oh, this happened. I never hoped this would happen. Oh my God. Oh my God. And then your life will be filled with all the gratitude, all the love. And it's like daily, it's like I'm thanking Ma Lakshmi. Oh, thank you so much, Ma. Thank you so much for being in my life. Thank you so much, Ma. I can't thank her enough. I can't thank her enough. And maybe this is what I lacked. Maybe I lacked a mother's love in my life, maybe. And this is what she is giving me. So maybe if you lack, Ma Lakshmi is nothing but abundance. So whatever you lack in your life, she would just shower it to you. So if you lack job, wealth, whatever, maybe she will shower it to you. But my wealth condition is okay. Not very wealthy, but not very poor as well. But I seriously lack somewhere mother's love in my life, and that's what Ma Lakshmi is showering me. So I am so grateful that I tried this mantra. I'm so grateful, and I'm in ecstasy right now, and to share with you all what I felt this whole year. It has been a great journey, and you also must try it. So if you want any tips, you can comment. I can share in the next video how you can dive into this mantra. If you want to try it, don't be silly like me. I was very silly. I was trying it and then expecting a result on the same day. I was trying it and then expecting a result on the next day. It will not happen like that. You need to forget about the result first, and then try it with all the love, all the devotion. Devotion is what I think is the key of any mantra. So if you are devoted and if you believe in the deity, and slowly it solidifies in you. So daily if you chant Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, you start believing in Shiva, whether you grew up with it or not. So daily if you chant Shreem Brzee, Shreem Brzee, Shreem Brzee, obviously you start believing in Ma Lakshmi. And when you do that, she will become your reality. She will sleep with you, she will eat with you, she will be with you always. And that's what it is. So thank you for listening. Thank you for tuning in. If you want any help with me, I think now I can share some tips. It doesn't require much tip because it's a mother and daughter relationship or mother and a son relationship. You call her, she will come. You tell her what you lack and she will give you what you need. Not what you want, but what you really need. And it will fill you with all the gratitude, all the love, and it will shower you with blessings. So thank you for tuning in. Bye-bye.